Democratic lawmakers are calling what their Republican counterparts did tonight an affront to democracy. The Wisconsin Senate passed a bill stripping collective bargaining rights from over 175,000 state employees. Senate Republicans voted 18-1. In what is being considered a bold political move, Republicans took collective bargaining out of the budget bill and voted without the Democrats. Before the votes were cast, Democratic Assemblyman Peter Barca made a last-ditch appeal to Senate Republicans, and of course, they ignored him. Now the bill heads to the Wisconsin Assembly for a vote tomorrow. It's expected to pass, and Governor Scott Walker will take over from there. Walker and his fellow Republicans in the Senate have been saying, actually all along, that collective bargaining was a fiscal issue. Well, tonight, they proved otherwise. They proved that this was really all about union busting, which they have been accused of all along. Governor Walker put out this statement following the vote of the Senate tonight. The Senate Democrats have had 3 weeks to debate this bill and were offered repeated opportunities to come home, which they refused. In order to move the state forward, I applaud the legislature's action today to stand up to the status quo and take a step in the right direction to balance the budget and reform government. That reforming of government is union busting, in my opinion. Wisconsin Democrats say that this was undemocratic and they plan to legally challenge it every step of the way. So at this hour, here is the scene. Protesters are now flocking back to the Capitol. The latest statement we have from Democratic Minority Leader Miller is, we will not be back in Wisconsin tomorrow. The Republicans basically today said, we're going to move without you.